are grateful to God. We are still in prayer. The Bible says that we should fast and pray. Where? Jesus said, when you fast. You know, fasting is a spiritual exercise. Jesus clearly said, this kind does not go except by prayer and fasting. And what kind? It is the ability to have faith. You see, many of us have concluded that when Jesus said this kind goeth not out except by prayer and fasting, it means he's dealing with the demons. But demons, they always have to be subjected to the name of Jesus. So that this kind that he's talking about is unbelief. Unbelief is really an enemy. And unbelief needs to be dealt with. That is why he said, this kind goeth not out. One of our enemies is unbelief. And unbelief makes us not to be able to receive faith by which we will please God and seek God. Because faith is a vital force. Faith is a powerful gift that God has given to man. So if we drain, somebody says that, doubt your doubts. So when we let the doubt go down, then our faith will rise up. Because when you have faith, you will know that impossible cases can be turned into possibility. Somebody said Jesus worked miracles. But if you read the Bible, even the bones of Elisha was able to raise the dead. So what we need to do is to, you know, when we fast, it means that we are draining out. We are taking out doubt and fear. And so we'll continue to fast and pray. One thing about the church is that once the Lord brings us deliverance and we think we are free, then another generation will rise up that will say, fasting is not good. Let's throw away fasting. I think I've seen quite some few generations that will rise up to criticize the things that brought us to where we are. So there's a generation that once in a while will rise up and say, too much fasting. We argue about fasting. We argue about tithing. And what it does is, that is the enemy trying to weaken us. And we call those things doctrine of demons. And we can be captured by it without realizing. And so today, we also are on day 8 of our fast. And today we are praying for the nations of the world. Nations of the world. One of the scriptures that I really like is that in Psalm 2 verse 8, it says, ask of me for the nations. Ask of me for the nations. So when we ask God for the nations, he's going to give it to us. In Isaiah chapter 2 verse 4, it says, he will judge between the nations and will settle disputes for many peoples. They will beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation will not take up sword against nation, nor will they train for war anymore. Psalm 22, 27 to 28 says, all the ends of the earth will remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nations will bow down before him. For dominion belongs to the Lord, and he rules over the nations. Jesus said, go ye into the world. It means go to the nations and teach them and tell them that the kingdom of God has come. And so today we are praying for nations. Why do we have to pray for nations? Because there's one vital thing that happened according to the book of Deuteronomy 32. In Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 8 and 9, it talks about the fact that nations were given to the gods. They were given to the gods of the nations. But when Jesus came, he overthrew them. Jesus came and said that, go ye into the world. Why? Because all authority in heaven and on earth has been given unto him. Go ye therefore in my name. So we are praying for the nations, and we are saying that principalities and powers of darkness, demons that hold nations, may they bow, to the name of Jesus, as we go with the good news, as we go with the gospel, Lord, we are praying that these nations will bow. You said we should ask for the nations. We should ask for the heathen. Lord, we are asking today, it's our prayer. Give us the nations. Give us the nations that do not know you. Give us the nations that are still under the yoke and the bondage of economic crisis, of human wickedness, of targeting and destruction. Lord, deliver us. Make it your prayer. Lift up your voice everywhere you are. Lift up your voice and let's pray that the nations that have blocked themselves against the gospel of the kingdom would let down the demons that make some nations be ruled by the spirit and the angel of poverty that we want to destroy. We want to pray for nations where there is war continually, that the Lord himself would set us free. The Lord would deliver us in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Today, day 8, as we are praying that you and I not only pray, but take steps and win one soul. One soul a day, one soul a week, one soul a month. At least speak to somebody and let them know that the nations have, the principalities over the nations have no power. But unless after prayer, we go with the gospel, preach the gospel, win a soul at least this week, and let Jesus be magnified and become Lord over the nations. Thank you very much, and God bless you for the effort. As you seek his face, may you hear his voice. May you receive freshness and fresh revelation. In Jesus' name, amen.